The Wild Robot by Peter Brown. A cargo ship sinks in a hurricane. Five crates wash ashore. There is only one survivor.
Hello, I am Rosam Unit 7134, but you may call me Roz.
Roz discovered that all the different animals shared one common language, which Roz learned to speak. Roz learns that if she wants to survive as long as possible in the wild, she will need the help of her new friends. But now the Ricos come to take Roz away.
Hello, Rosam Unit 7134. We are the Ricos. We are here to retrieve all Rosam units.
Torn between the love of her friends and her duty as a robot, will she go or will she stay and become the Wild Robot? Read this book to find out.
Have you ever wondered what it was like to be a world record breaker? Well, this kid, Tenny Mars, is. Well, almost. Tenny Mars, almost a world record breaker by Molly B. Burnham. Illustrated by Trevor Spencer. The day Teddy's brother climbed into the cat box was the day he knew his wife would never be normal again. And that's saying something because his wife was not normal to begin with. But Jake, he's like the first time you opened the Guinness Book of World Records. All you can do is think about it all day long. Wani, a Star Wars fan himself, and Fiva, the new kid in school, will help Teddy become a record breaker.
Says Shank, clinging helplessly to the old sled. We'd be on top of the world already since they're going so fast. No, they're not. It's not just about being fast, you also have luck. It will take a week and lots of stuff might happen along the way, I suppose. What will you wish for when we get there first? What's your heart's desire, Shen? Seiko is really into winning, but they didn't forget they were the racers. Snowbot, how's it coming along with digging out our sled team?
Almost done, Shackleton Jones.
How you doing, my little huskies?
Give me my rocket launcher, side plate. Time to cheat.
Yes, sir. Fine. Pugs and Frogs of the North at your local library to join in on the action, adventure, fun, and all the hilarious things that'll happen along the way.
Recommend this book
for us as family.
For your friends and family.
Because
it's amazing!
Ferocious Fluffy is a book about kids that don't listen to their teacher.
Mr. J told the class not to take Fluffity out of the cage.
Where's Fluffity?
What's going to happen next?
Castlevania by Ursula Vernon. Molly versus Eudaimonia. Will you drain the moat? Yes. Thank you. Seeds and spells. We can walk across. What are you doing? Gardening. You turn the stones into cheese? Sharks and Shadows Magic Unbound. Break her wand. No, don't let it get me. I'll leave you alone. Stop, Shadow. Molly? No, I won't go with you. Yay, we got the castle back!
Narrow Unicorn of the Sea by Ben Clinton, citation page 41, narrated by Katie Wong, Charles Elementary, first grade. I'm gonna sing the song on page 41. I am a narwhal, a happy little narwhal. I like parties, I like waffles because I'm a narwhal. Happy little narwhal. I'm gonna do the same thing, but it's a turtle. I am a turtle. A happy little turtle. I like parties. I like waffles because I'm a turtle. A happy little turtle. Done.
Thank you.
Hello, I am Roz.
Oh, look. There's something over there. This fire is so warm and toasty. I feel like I was just thrown into a volcano.
Oh, wow. It's so windy.
Ah. Oh, look. An egg. Hi, Bright Bill.
Hi, Mommy.
Good boy.
Challenges arise. Will Roz be able to save the island?
Yay, I'm migrating!
Bad guys, we talk like the bad guys, and we eat and sleep very bad. But do you know who we are? This is Mr. Wolf, this is Mr. Brown, and this is Mr. Snake. And I'm Mr. Shark, and yes, we are the bad guys, but we are ready to change that. Bad Guys is my favorite slam book, written by Arnold Bay. The gang is going to set free 200 dogs out of the city dog pound. Mr. Wolf has plans for the bad guys' first good mission. Do you think this will operate the dog pound will go well? Will the bad guys become the good guys? Go read this book. You will love it, and you will laugh so much.
Who fired it?
Trip in outer space. He gets so excited that he gets left behind. Willie has to try to go and find his classmates. Will he make it?
We don't know. Why won't you read this book and find out?
You will find this book at Mr. Flagg's library.
Bye guys!
Maxie's Secrets by Lynn Plourde. Enjoy.
This is Maxie. She is deaf and her owner is Timony.
This is Timony. He owns Maxie. He just moved and he gets bullied by Rory a lot at school. Even though Timony got bullied, he still had Maxie to keep him company.
Maxie had to get rushed to the vet because she got pricked by a porcupine.
Timony's new neighbor is Abby. She is blind.
There was a bad snowstorm and Abby got lost, so Maxie went to go get Abby, and Rory went on his ATV to look for Maxie and Abby.
What will happen next? Read the book to find out.
This book inspired me because Thunderboy Sr. knew that Thunderboy Jr. wanted a new name.
My name is Thunderboy Jr.
This is my dad, Thunderboy Sr. My dad gave me my name.
My mom wanted to name me Sam. Sam is a normal name.
I really want my own name. I want to be myself.
I once climbed a mountain, so call me Touch the Clouds.
My dog chases me, so call me Can't Run Fast While Laughing.
I love my dad, but I don't want to be Little Thunder.
I'm going to give you your own name, Lightning.
My dad gave me a new name.
Now my dad is Thunder, and I am Lightning, and we are a team.
Coin by Kate Egan,
with magician Mike Lane, book trailer by Ariana B. and Lindsay G. Mike gets in trouble a lot, which makes him sad. One day, he and his neighbor found a magic shop. Mr. Zerlin, the magician, gives them a riddle to solve. Mike struggles at the first one, but then he soon starts loving magic! Once Mike learns magic tricks, he starts showing his friends during lunch. Soon, life gets much better. If you want to read more of Mike's magic tricks, read The Vanishing Coin.
You will hear about Douglas Heaney Glasses by Ged Adamson. First of all, his owner kicks a ball and Douglas comes back with a bee's nest. And this is how it starts. It starts with glasses. Well, actually, they were going to a glasses store. Then they find an eye doctor. He showed them a big shelf of glasses. The one he wanted was purple. I hope you're going to enjoy the book. Bye!
Yeah, I'm talking to you.
Yeah, you. You should read the book, The Bad Guys, by Aaron Blake.
In the book, The Bad Guys, there are four bad guys. Wolf, snake, shark, and piranha. But guess what? They don't want to be known as bad guys anymore. They are tired of being villains. They are tired of all the screams. And most of all, they are tired of all the fear. They want to be known as the good guys.
They're a business for the good guys, because it's to prove that they are good guys. Wolf had a great idea. Going out and looking for someone who needs their help.
Good guys, lucky day. They found a cat stuck in a tree and needed help. In the end, they were able to save the cat, but it didn't go as smoothly as planned.
Their big mission, Operation Dog Pound, the bad guys plan on freeing 200 puppies from the maximum security city dog pound, trapped behind walls of stone and bars of steel.
Will they succeed? Will the bad guys really become the good guys?
You have to read The Bad Guys by Aaron Blaine to find out.
About The Vanishing Coin by Kate Egan and Mike Lane. The Vanishing Coin is a coin trick you will never forget. Micah and Jenny take a trip to the White Rabbit store. The door is white, the carpet says believe, and when you go in there's a magician behind the cash register. The two kids learn about teamwork, magic tricks, and never giving up. It can even teach you this trick. You can read the magic The Vanishing Coin today. Bye!
Hey guys, I'm Marcos, and today we're going to be talking about a book named The Wild Robot. As you can see, it's called The Wild Robot because it was this robot named Roz. She washed up on Schwerfer from this big storm. When I say big, it was so big because it made tsunamis and it made ships sink, really big ships sink in the ocean. When this robot, Roz, washed up on shore, she started to learn about, like, the wild and stuff. And at one point in the book, I remember she learned something from this animal. She learned how to camel. And if you want to learn more about the book, check it out. It's called The Wild Robot. Bye.
Oh no! Shipwreck! The only thing left from the wreckage is a floating crate. The crate helplessly drifted, crashing towards the rocks until it's washed up against the shore of an island. Curious otters approach the beaten down crate and with a few words, clicks a robot suddenly bursts to life. The animals flee in terror of the horrible monster. But the robot called out to the empty island in a monotone voice. I am Rosan 7183. What is a robot doing on an island? How will she survive the savageness of the forest? Maybe if she does not take the insults from the forest creatures seriously and be friends with them, she might survive or might not. Read the magnificent and unforgettable novel by exceptional author Peter Brown.
Cut. Hi, my name is Jack, and I read this book, Douglas You Need Glasses. It was written by Jed Adamson.
Oh, I forgot.
That's better. This book is about using glasses as a tool. My glasses help me see. Douglas needed glasses.
Hi, my name is Mike, and I have lots of energy. I always stand, and I'm not cheating. It's just I have too much energy, and this is my neighbor, Nora.
Hi, my name is Nora. I'm Mike's neighbor. In the book, we go to a shop called The White Rabbit. A man gave us a challenge. The challenge was we had a piece of paper and a pair of scissors. We had to make a hole so we could cut through it. I didn't figure it out.
I did.
In the book, we learned that the White Rabbit was a magic shop. We learned so many tricks. Hit it, Mike! Anyways, back to me. We used the tricks that we learned against a boy named Matt Jackson. He's not very nice. Read the book to find out what tricks we used against Jackson by Kate Egan.
Hi, my name is Amaya.
And my name is Vivian.
This story is called The Daddy Said March and the Mini Bees. It is about three kids going to sell chocolate so that they can raise money for the science field trip. Then they go to a street with an abandoned house. They go inside and find out that it is a secret laboratory. A scientist pops out and scares them. Also, the scientist saw that one of the kids had a toy dinosaur. And the scientist grabs it and tries to do an investigation, but it does not work.
So he repowers it, and he tried it another time. It worked. It made his toy come to life. The scientist follows the kids back to the back to their treehouse and saw the kids who had the toy. He had a whole bucket full of toys. So the scientists made all of the toys turn into real animals. And that is what the story is all about.
Hello, my name is Weesum.
Hello, my name is Hisham.
We're showing you our SWAM project. The illustrator is Jed Adamson. The characters are Douglas and Nancy. My favorite part is when Douglas thought he was chasing squirrels.
It's my turn. The author is Jed Adamson. The characters are Nancy and Douglas. My favorite part is when Douglas actually got the beehive instead of the ball when they were playing catch. Wait. Then the plot is Douglas needs glasses because he can't see really well. So he went to an optician and he got new glasses. That is the end of our SLAM project.
Bye!
And this is Nicole, and today we're going to be talking about the book Save Me a Seat by Sierra Weeks.
This book is mainly about two boys that are very different from each other and are both stuck in the same place,
school. The theme of the story is to never judge a book by its cover.
Because
at first, Ravi thought that Joe was a bully and not very smart. But they didn't really know each other.
And Joe's perspective about Ravi was that he was very different from everybody else in the classroom.
Only because he was from India. They ended up being friends, and they have one thing in common. Their enemy, Dylan.
Ali first at last by Zion. Ali and Sarah go to school. Here comes Henry. They discuss a contest. It is finally time for the contest. Ali changes her mind and does a different script, which is against the rules. Read Ali first at last to find out what happens, if she wins or lose.
Thank you.
I have superpowers.
Who are you?
I am the robot of the decider. I am here to grant your six powers. Nemesis is coming!
We need to unmask Star Guy.
Slayer video. I read a book named Willy Making a Space. The story is about a fourth grader that their class went to space and they left him in Planet Ed with a girl, and they met a kid that looked like an alien, and then a monster chased them. They ran and ran. Then the monster got stuck in the park, and then Willy helped him get out. If you want to read this book, you can go to your school library or town library, and this book is cool.
Mike finally solves the riddle. The kids are impressed and amazed by Mike's magic. Mike and Nora are entering the magic shop for some accessories.
Mike cannot check out the Book of Secrets.
Mike and Nora open the Book of Secrets. Mike's dad calls all of a sudden. On the wall it says, "Believe."
Hi, my name is Willy Make It, a fourth grader. We went on a field trip to Planet Ed. We almost died, but here's some safety tips to survive on Planet Ed.
Water, just in case of the emergency.
This is when Willy Make It is going fishing to find food for his friends.
Willy Make It thought this purple fruit was poisonous, but when he tried it, he said it was a good food to survive on Planet Ed.
There's a bear on my chair by Lost Clumps. Hey, there's a bear on my chair. I can push him off of my chair. Maybe I'll give him a nasty glare. Maybe I'll drop out of my underwear. Boo! Maybe I could tame him with a pair. Nope, he doesn't want it. That's it! I'm done!
Hey, there's a mouse in my house.
This little girl thought she could steal my place as master of Castle Hangnail.
You threw the invitation in the trash can!
You thought you could fool the board and the minions into thinking you were the evil sorceress?
But I did all the tests! Smiting, blinding, and defending the castle!
Oh, dear Molly.
Don't dear Molly me. Soon that hat of yours will be mine. Let's let the readers decide.